Hello everyone, let's move on to the strategy chapter and delve into a new topic within advanced strategy, intellectual property strategy. First, let's talk about intellectual property. It's essentially a product of the mind, something developed through intellectual effort. The rights to its ownership. Let me give you an example. Have any of you read the book, The Ghost Blows Out the Lights series, or seen its film and TV adaptations? Like Path Through Shaanxi or Dragon's Royal Maze and other titles, right? Many of you have probably seen these. The author of this series is Tian Jiabaquan. Tian Jiabaquan wrote The Ghost Blows Out the Lights series. When he wrote The Ghost Blows Out the Lights series, he sold it to KDN Chinese Network for a relatively low price. Later, as it happened, KDN Chinese Network became part of Yuan Group. So the copyright for this series now belongs to Yuan Group, but not in Tian Jiabaquan's own hands. Later, he went on to write new works, which were adapted into films and TV series. And when adapting these works, they titled them Ghost Blows Out the Light. Later, he was sued by a certain company. After the lawsuit, he had to pay a large sum in damages. And the key is, he lost the lawsuit. In other words, without owning the copyright, he couldn't use the title Ghost Blows Out the Light anymore. He couldn't use it that way. Now, some people might think that it's really quite unbelievable. You can write a book and not even own the copyright. Exactly. Because you've sold the copyright. Sold it, in fact. And they've paid for it. This brings us to a very interesting point. Intellectual property. Intellectual property covers many things. First, there's patent right. What's a patent right? It's the patent for an invention. Patents for inventions. Take Qualcomm, for example. They are often called a patent troll. They hold numerous patents. They thrive just by licensing patents, like the old 3G and 4G technologies in mobile phones. Many are their patents. So just by licensing patents, they make a great living. Okay, what's a patent? It's the patents you develop. Okay, so your inventions and creations and the interests authorized by the government, these are patents. If others want to use them, they need to pay you or get your authorization. Then there's copyright. For copyright, we just saw, like the one between Tian Jiabaquan and Ghost Blows Out the Light. He no longer holds the copyright for Ghost Blows Out the Light. That is, to create literary works or paintings, musical works and so on. Then you'll own the copyright to them. You'll have the rights to distribute, print, and produce them. That's your copyright. For example, let me see, I think it was Cindy Wang, right? Everyone was listening to her. Yeah. Cindy Wang once said, every year, just from her songs, copyright revenue, it reaches 8 or 9 figures. It's like this. This is what copyright is. And the songs he performs can continuously generate revenue for the copyright holders. Some people write books, and they might rely on just one book to continuously collect royalties and receive a good income. Of course, writing a good book isn't easy. It requires a lot of talent. Now, let's look at another one called trademark rights. What are trademark rights? You might register certain symbols, words or phrase as a trademark. For example, here, this C is a trademark. So once you have this trademark, if it's registered and approved, once it becomes your trademark, others can't use it anymore. Just how powerful can a trademark be? You've probably heard about the trademark battle between Wang Laoji and Jia Duobao, right? They spent tons of money on legal fees to determine if it belonged to Wang Laoji or Jia Duobao. And then later, they each went their own way, and so on. So about this trademark, what are the advantages? You know, a trademark that's already widely recognized is extremely valuable. You might have heard of certain clothing or underwear brands. They may have stopped running their own factories. They simply take their brand's label and sell it to these smaller companies, or license it to them. These smaller companies then brand the products themselves, producing and selling them under that label. So when you buy clothes from these brands, you might find the quality to be inconsistent. This can happen, right? And then there are many others, like what's it called? Like DMs or contract manufacturers and so on. Many of these companies only handle the design aspect, leaving the actual manufacturing to other companies. Since they hold the IP rights and the copyright for the design, they can have others produce it. They take the finished product, resell it, and make a hefty profit. So that's a quick rundown of IP rights. Another type is called plant variety rights. It is also a type of intellectual property. It specifically relates to plants. When new plant varieties are developed or cultivated, when something new emerges in this field, the government grants certain rights. This is to protect the researchers involved. For example, there was a case involving the Yahoo Research Institute, which was related to a certain long, some kind of rice seed. This company with the ownership rights. Then a certain Mr. Lee. He took this seed and bred some new seeds from it, and then sold them. Yahoo Research Institute found out and sued. The final verdict was that Mr. Lee had to destroy all of his seeds and parent stock, because only Yahoo Research Institute holds the plant variety rights for it. Because it took a lot of effort to develop this variety, you can't just take credit for others' work. You need to get authorization from them. Besides producing this or reproducing it, selling it is also included. As well as producing or growing it, take certain drugs, for example. You're not allowed to just grow them anywhere, but they can be grown in certain places. The state specifically authorizes their cultivation. Once grown, it can be used to make medicine. That's why these plant variety rights are necessary. Take, for instance, a specific type of apple. Only your company can sell it. That's where plant variety rights come in. Others can't sell it. Lastly, there are trade secrets. Now, regarding trade secrets, how can I explain this? They might seem far removed from our daily lives, but there's something you're probably more familiar with, and that's a non-compete agreement you might have signed. Once you're hired, you might have signed a non-compete agreement. When you leave, the company will pay you a certain amount, and for a period of time, you can't work for a direct competitor. Especially if you're a key employee. This is likely prohibited, right? The concern here is that you might take the trade secrets from your previous company and use them at your new job. That's why trade secrets are confidential. It shouldn't be disclosed to the public. If you disclose it, wouldn't that be corporate espionage or something, right? That's a problem. So it can't be disclosed, but it's still valuable. So this all needs to be kept confidential. Of course, protecting trade secrets is actually very difficult. Some companies even would, for instance, poach talent from another company. This company might have to pay $3 million for poaching this talent. It doesn't matter, they have deep pockets. They're willing to pay the $3 million and use other people's work, it happens. So all of this is intellectual property, all created through intellectual work. Whether it's research and development, invention, works of writing and design, trademark applications, or new plant varieties. This also includes trade secrets. These are all forms of intellectual property.